Most people in America are familiar with the rights of an individual to choose and purchase at the age of adulthood, or possibly earlier, with their own income or funds, their own clothing. We are also very familiar that in America we are not a monopolized citizenry in which we have to wear some sort of uniform in public like you might find in Japan with regard to manufacturing is not true. We actually have manufacturing uniforms, we have restaurant uniforms, we have all kinds of uniforms. But when it comes to our private life and our private time and our Saturday afternoons, we are allowed to choose our own clothing. What I'm highlighting today is how certain bastards of the force think that we should go back to men and women's clothing. And for some time, one of my favorite shirts for my manhood, that the Lord led me to in a probably Goodwill store, has been playing with, and that someone has been folding and creasing my shirt to make it look, I hate to say it, more feminine, as if they were going to take my shirt and change the direction of which the buttons lay on the shirt. Most people know that when a man buttons his shirt, the buttons typically today go basically in the which that the article of clothing goes left over right, and a female's shirt goes right over left. And that may or may not be correct, but that's what I've noticed and observed in current clothing. I also know that we've gone to a much more unisex style of creating clothing because manufacturers that are actually producing clothing through machinery are concerned with efficiency and economy of the cost of the clothing so that they can get the most cost benefits out of the amount that's going to provide for their corporations and mainly their people and staff who do that work for their living. And that means that if they've got two shirts, a man's shirt and a woman's shirt, that is basically the same fabric, they can print them all at the same time, and then they can just slightly make very slight variations in the way that the buttons lay or the way that the shirt is gathered and things like that. I'm also talking about the way that people like to make fun of people who they don't remember old gentlemanly ways on. And the difference of being a gentleman and the difference of being a man today may be very different. We also have a very bastardized group of religious people who think they have the right to tell someone who's sort of on a sliding scale of spectrum of gender how they can and can't dress. There are many immoral and highly illegal religious pastors and ministers that if they are faced with a parent saying, I'm not sure what to do with my kid, I think he may be gay, that they'll automatically say, well, go put him in a dress or whatever. And the reality is that is an immoral response. Most of the time, kids are just in a moment of exploration and parents should let it play out and just be loving and kind because regardless of how the Lord made them, they have a right to choose their fashion, to choose their fabric, to choose their sizing, and to choose what makes them feel best and most productive in a workplace of their lives, whether it's education in terms of schooling, high school, college, and whatnot, which is typically when those indications start really revealing themselves in terms of relationships, but at the same time in the workforce in the future. America is most definitely about a balance of equality in the employment realm, and that we know that there are many, many wealthy people of all walks of life around town. And people do not get to pick and choose within those groups and discriminate who will and won't be successful.